It towers above the runway. It carries tanks, helicopters, even entire armies. And for more than half a century, it has been the backbone of America's global military power. This is the C-5M Super Galaxy, the largest military aircraft in the world. A machine so big, it doesn't just carry cargo, it carries the weight of history. The 1960s. The Cold War is at its height. The United States needs more than just fighters and bombers. It needs logistics on a scale never seen before. The Douglas C-133 Cargo Master and the Lockheed C-141 Starlifter could carry plenty, but not enough. The Pentagon wanted something bigger, much bigger. In 1963, the Air Force launched the CX project, a design program for a new heavy lift aircraft. At first, it was imagined with 6 engines, but engineers soon found a way to do more with less, streamlining it into a 4-engine design. But its secret weapon? The TF-39 high bypass turbofan engine, a revolutionary leap that not only transformed military aviation, but paved the way for commercial giants like the Boeing 747. By 1965, Lockheed won the contract. A new legend was about to take flight.
Thank you.
The first variant, the C-5A, rolled out in the late 1960s. Its size alone was staggering. 75 meters long, 20 meters tall, with a wingspan wider than a football field. For the US Air Force, it was a game changer. Tanks, armored vehicles, even attack helicopters could be flown across oceans. Wars could be supplied in days, not weeks. But the Galaxy wasn't perfect. Early models suffered from wing cracks and structural issues. These problems could have ended the program. Instead, the Air Force doubled down, fixing the flaws and proving their commitment to the world's largest airlifter. From then on, the Galaxy would only get better. The C-5 wasn't a one-time wonder. It was the start of a dynasty. C-5B, introduced in the 1980s, with stronger wings, modernized avionics, and more reliable engines. C-5C, a rare variant built for oversized space cargo, like satellites and rocket parts. C-5M Super Galaxy, the ultimate version, upgraded with new engines, digital avionics, and extended service life, bringing the aircraft into the 21st century. Today, the Air Force operates 52 C-5M Super Galaxies, and each one is still vital to U.S. global operations. The Galaxy isn't just about transporting tanks and trucks. It's also a flying hospital. The Aeromedical Evacuation Squadron uses the C-5M for life-saving missions, training with realistic scenarios aboard the aircraft itself. Medical teams practice treating critical patients in mid-flight, replicating the chaos and pressure of real emergencies. These missions ensure the aircraft can switch from warfighter to lifesaver in a matter of hours.
Unable cruise altitude knowledge.
Point one, good.
24-1, Alaska 828, connect.
Alright, push mode is armed 3170.
Powered up 534 heavy and Fox 2, ready to push.
300. Landing crew.
And Honolulu, ground Hawaiian 1689 heavy.
100.
Looking 2414, like the push. 1689 heavy Honolulu.
50. 40.
Sorry, we're in hard set.
30.
Bravo and
20.
410.
10.
1689 at the end, cross at Alpha, Alpha Victor.
Kill by taxi light, please. Off. Fuel alert system. Fuel alert system.
But with great size comes great responsibility. Maintaining the C-5 is nothing short of colossal. Its landing gear alone weighs 172,000 kilograms. To lift the aircraft for repairs, six enormous hydraulic jacks are placed under its frame, each capable of hoisting more than 60 tons. Drones now assist with inspections, flying around the 20-meter tall fuselage to spot cracks and wear before humans even see them. Every mission begins with a meticulous inspection of engines, hydraulics, avionics, and control surfaces, ensuring nothing is left to chance. And the cost? Astronomical. The Air Force once admitted spending $10 million on a single toilet cover for the C-5. Why? Because replacement parts are no longer mass-produced. They must be custom-made, sometimes at prices that sound almost absurd. To reduce costs, the Air Force has turned to 3D printing, creating new parts for old giants. Without it, the galaxy might not still be flying. Behind the technology, it's the crew that makes the galaxy soar. Flight engineers monitor and manage its incredibly complex systems. Loadmasters calculate cargo balance, ensuring the aircraft stays stable in the air. Their training blends classroom knowledge with real-world drills. Because when you're flying a machine this massive, mistakes are not an option.